portion of the cruise where we realize this thing is never going to end.
Right. It's 15 days, right? 15 days.
70 blurred days.
How y'all doing?
First question. How badass was Arecibo, you guys, that went over? And how incredibly overcrowded was the museum and snack bar?
Locusts, like locusts.
Just kind of ripping leaves from the trees and tearing the name tags off the lady at the gift shop. Anything is a memento.
Panels off the dish.
Okay, a few quick announcements. We have a lost badge and room key. And the winner is Brian Silverstein.
Oh, no.
Hey, just a moderate, gentle, kind shaming as he walks by.
Shit.
Maybe you shouldn't have done that. Those of you who purchased internet packages, as a reminder, keep checking to see if your discount has been applied yet. If by the last day of the cruise, which is 700 hours from now,
2017,
if it has not been applied by 2017 or day 8 of this cruise, please check at the front desk and make sure that they take care of that for you. Again, as a reminder, there will be onboard booking forms for JoCo Cruise 2016 in the back of the room here, as well as at the C1E info desk down on 2.
Hold on. What drink is that? That looks amazing.
This is
a frozen mudslide.
Yeah. Oh, that looks amazing.
Look at this thing of beauty.
Okay.
So that's,
thanks very much.
I totally forgot that we're getting a bucket drink on these mudslides. You gotta push it.
That's right.
Look at this wonderful drink. Unpaid endorsement.
The Jackson Pollock of frozen beverages.
Let's see. Let us go through the schedule. Oh, one thing to note. This evening, the drinking and drawing session with Matt Long and friends is officially happening at 9 p.m. in the Solarium pool area so that there's enough room for all of you drunks. There's a number of tables that are very well lit there. If you are an artist taking part in that, that's where and when it's going to be. And if you're a person buying drinks for the artists, that's where it's going
to
be. Do you have to have talent?
No.
There you have it.
Let us stop me.
Yeah, look at us. So tonight, right here in this room, in a scant few minutes, Jim Boggia and Bo. Tonight's dinner, as a reminder, is formal in the main dining room. And at 9 o'clock in Studio B is the first ever, possibly last ever, depending on levels of disaster and drunkenness, fancy schmancy skate party.
Please don't break your ankles. Yes.
Couple of notes. Number one, please don't break your ankles. Number two, skate, then drink. Say it with us. Skate, then drink. Now once you guys. Another note, please be as careful as you can. Obviously there's no drinking on the ice because you people aren't complete idiots. But we'll say anyway, no drinks on the ice. Please be careful with your drinks near the ice, because if you spill a drink on the, glice, they have to melt the whole thing and clean it off. It takes a long time, and they can't do anything in that room.
You'll like ruin it for everybody.
You'll ruin everything for everybody. So if you are drinking, please keep it several rows away from the ice if you can to be safe.
Okay, Mom, thanks.
Like you're going skating, John-Roderick. Like you're the guy that has to pay to melt the ice. Cruise villain. It is Pacific Northwest Dandywear.
That's a good brand name for his line of clothing.
Yeah.
John-Roderick-specific Northwest Dandywear.
P-L-E-D.
Lumber sexual missile. skating, they're allowed up to 50 skaters at a time, and it is free to skate. There is no skate rental cost, but you must sign a waiver, which means you must be capable of signing your name. And finally, the staff running the skate rental do retain the right to refuse skate rental to anybody for any reason. Don't try and skate drunk. Let's say it one more time. Skate and then drink. Thank you.
Too late. Tomorrow,
we are in Labadee. Gonna get our beach on. Tomorrow night, you're all on your own recognizances.
A new thing for JoCo Cruise.
But also don't forget that tonight, here in this very room at 11 p.m., is many people's favorite, Celebrity Artists. And those are the morning announcements.
Those of you who saw the Band on the Run performance, who are familiar with Jim Boggia's work, will know that he didn't look like he was talented just because we were so bad. He is a fantastic musician, and he makes me want to punch him in the face every time I see him play or hear him sing. His audition last year went pretty well, so we brought him back this year. Please welcome Jim Boggia.